Hello, YouTube. I want to keep this introduction short because one of the things I hate the most about reaction videos is the intro being too long. So basically, the rundown of what this is a VOD of one of my streams over on Twitch where I reacted to the entire Imagine Dragons Mercury Act 1 album, and I put it into a tier list from As Good As Radioactive all the way down to Ass Cheeks. Now, As Good As Radioactive doesn't actually mean I think Radioactive is the greatest song overall. It really just means that it's a very, very good song. So I hope you guys enjoy. Let me know down in the comments what you think of each song, and I'll see you guys in the next video. So this is how it's gonna work. We're gonna listen to the song all the way through, because the one thing I hate about those YouTube videos where they just pause the music like halfway through, it's like kind of sucks. Like, I want to hear their comments, but how about we listen to it all the way through once, and then I will comment on it, and then we'll rank it. So the first song that we'll be listening to is called My Life. I'll put the lyrics up on the screen. We can all listen to it together and be so happy. So this is the beginning of Mercury Act 1, apparently the Japanese edition, but that's okay, because it's not. Okay, here we go, dudes. All the way up with the music, already talking, so disrespectful. It's okay though.
Can I wish on a star for another life? Cause it feels like I'm all on my own tonight, and I find myself in pieces. There are pills on the table and a thought in my head, and I walk through the halls where I used to be led. My heart is filled with reasons. I'm trying to be somebody else. I'm finding it hard to love myself. I wanted to be somebody new, but that is impossible to do. I'm running out of my mind. Is this really my life? I'm running out of time. Is this really my life? My life. These years pass by and we're growing older, and I think of you. Oh, we've made it through. Some have passed away, some have moved on, but I'm still here today.
Oh! Okay, so this is what I'll say. It's a very good start. The thing that draws my attention to this song is the little piano in like the pre-chorus that pops off into the chorus. That's the first thing I notice. I really fucking like that. The next thing I notice is when it comes down to the refrains, I used to think that Imagine Dragons was like average, and maybe a lot of people do. Like, I didn't think that they were that good. Like, Radioactive was good. Like, those singles were good. I never really liked the rest of it until I went and saw them live, and they are definitely in the top three best bands I've ever seen live. Like, every single song. Because I think that one thing that I don't really like about some music is, like, you know when it sounds just electronic and it's just like little beep boops and it's not like real instruments. Maybe that was just a thing that's always bothered me. And so that was how a lot of Imagine Dragons was for me, especially their album Smoke and Mirrors. But then when I saw them live and saw them actually playing the instruments and like just the production and everything, it was just fantastic. And so ever since I saw them live, I just think of all their songs. I think of it as if they're going to be live. And this is one of those songs that if their tour and their concert started off with this song, it would start with the little piano. It's like the whole fucking build-up thing. And then, boom, it just fucking explodes. And I could already see myself just being so happy by that. And so if we were to go to this list, of course, I think that we could have probably 3 or 4 more tiers in between As Good As Radioactive and Ass Cheeks. Because this is pretty broad if we're saying that the middle is average. But so for me, my life, it's not even close to As Good As Radioactive. But it's definitely not average. Now, maybe that will change if these other ones like blow me away. But my life is a very strong start to the album. And I think that's very good. And next up, we have Lonely, which is something I think a lot of us feel and have felt over the last year and a half, 2 years. But so, let's see. Sometimes I can get a little, lonely. Sometimes I can get a little, lonely. Some nights I get a little lonely. It's even when there's people all around me. Sometimes I get a little anxious because these pills don't work the way the doctor plays. The brim, hand on a limb, taking it in, sleep it away, life in a day, in a day in a life, mixing it up, checking it twice, trying to breathe, starting to seize, lights, camera, action and scene, story of my life. Oh, love, have mercy on me. Oh, that's it. Okay, so Lonely, it made me bob my head. But if I'm going to be honest, I think I'm going to put it in the average. I think it's something that will make my like playlist that I listen to, because it's like a little fucking dancey thing, right? I mean, really, I have a playlist for basically being sad, a playlist for being happy. The being happy one would be like everyone's got their summer playlist, right? It's always a good time. This is a song that I'd put, even though it's called Lonely, I think I'd put it in my like summer playlist. But so Lonely, we're going to put an average. Now, of course, this can always change. This doesn't always have to stay this way. But for now, Lonely's going to go average. It's not bad, but it's not a bop that I'd listen to. Now, Wrecked is a single that came off of the album. And I've heard it, and it's already in my playlist. But we'll see where we put it.
Days pass by and my eyes stay dry, and I think that I'm okay, till I find myself in a conversation fading away. The way you smile, the way you walk, the time you took to teach me all that you had taught. Tell me, how am I supposed to move on? These days I'm becoming everything that I hate, wishing you were around, but now it's too late. My mind is a place that I can't escape your ghost. Sometimes I wish that I could wish it all away. One more rainy day without you. Sometimes I wish that I could see you one more day. One more rainy day. Oh, I'm a wreck without you here. Yeah, I'm a wreck since you. Tried to put
So I believe this song was written because there was a family members of Dan Reynolds, the singer, who passed away. But, I mean, it's one of those things where obviously it's just a song about losing someone. Now, my favorite song from Imagine Dragons is actually from their last album. It's called Birds. And it's very much on the same theme. And it's just very good. I don't think that this song holds up to Birds in any way, but typically their singles are all bops. And so Wrecked, I would put right up there with My Life. There's not much I need to say on it because it's been out for so long, so I've heard it a million times. And it makes you get in your feels, and it also makes you be happy. That's not true. I don't even know why I said that. So next up, we got Monday, which is definitely the worst day out of the week here.
Ooh. When you're down on your luck, I take the best and I turn it up. When you face to the floor, I tell the dial, turn it up more.
Okay, look, so the vibes I'm getting from the song, first of all, he starts off by saying, you are my Monday, you're the best day of the week, which is entirely not true. But you know, starting at the instrumental break, whatever you'd call that, like guitar solo type thing, and going to the outro, this little section here, I feel like it was just designed to like make you smile. Like that moment right there, like gave me hope that maybe, you know, Monday isn't too bad. And then like with the little do-do-do-do-do-do, I like could imagine myself just like waking up on Monday. It's like the movies, and then you're just like walking down the road and it's like so happy. Like do-do-do-do-do-do. And that's the vibe I got from Monday. I'm gonna say it. I think I'm putting it in A tier. It may go down again, depending on what we get next. But like, that was pretty nice. I just wanted to like get up and dance, you know? So the next song is titled Number One.
Someone take me home.
So lo-fi.
I'm on my back again. Caught up in something. Someone take me home. I could use a friendly face. These leeches got to go. Yeah, I need a safe space. When am I gonna learn? I've got to let this go. Watching my candle burn.
one.
So number one, the way I'd put this is it's a great message. It's to really bring up the confidence in yourself. Self-confidence, self-love. But I don't think it's really for me. It's not ass cheeks. But like compared to Monday had me like wanting to get up on my feet and like get out. I would like, that is what made me happy. And personally for me, I feel like confidence follows happiness. I feel like if you're happy, you're confident. But I don't think you could just be confident and not happy. And this song didn't really make me happy. So number one, I'm going to actually put at a C. Because it's not bad. If it came on and I was on like a long drive, I'd leave it playing. But I'm not going to go out of my way to play that song. Unless what normally happens with Imagine Dragons is I'll go and I'll see them live. And then all the songs that I thought were eh become fire. And then they join my playlist. So maybe after like a year. So the next one is Easy Come, Easy Go. Produced by not Jason Derulo, but Jason D'Azuzio. All right. Oh. It's like getting up slow. It's like, I don't want to get out of bed today. That's what that sounds like.
All my friends are gone. I don't blame them. I guess I move on. Do the same thing. So I wrote a song to be my lullaby. Sing me to sleep at night. Open my third eye. I'm not gonna lie to you. I miss you so much. Tell me what I did wrong to lose touch. I'm not gonna lie to you. This has been a hard year. How I wish that you were here. I just need to let it go. Waiting on a miracle. Guess it's just the way it goes. Easy come, easy go. I just need to let it go. Turn it down and everyone in school, while you sitting at home in your wheelchair of grief, find no relief. We were there for the ups and downs, and there for the cons of rounds of chemo. Yeah, you know that you are our hero. You were there when I was a zero. And I swear I'll make things right before the long night. I swear I'll make things right tomorrow. But as for tonight, I just need to let it go. Waiting on a miracle. Guess it's just the way it goes. Easy come.
Easy come, easy go. Now, this song is obviously, it's about going through that treatment. And I feel like something in my life that I've seen, that being cancer and what it does to the people experiencing it, as well as the people having to witness all of it go down. I think that it's one of those things that even just like talking about it, like make me sad after seeing that in, I mean, all sorts of people, young and old. I mean, it's in everyone's life, whether or not they're directly impacted, whether it be a family member or not. It obviously sucks. And I think in this song, I think is exactly like, there's not really much when you're watching someone have to go through this. There's really not much you can do other than hope. I don't think you could put something like that as good as Radioactive, because generally I don't think people are going to listen to this song to like fucking headbang. But it's not even average, I'd say. Like, if I were, it's very possible that by the end of this ranking I may move average to the C tier and then put a B, because the way that these are going, I wouldn't put Monday with Easy Come Easy Go, but it's not average. And I'd say that like number one is average. Like, I haven't heard anything bad. So that may be what I do. I think it's like that. I have to go back and hear Lonely again. Just a little bit of it. Oh, it's this one. That's right.
Some nights I get a little
Yeah, I'd keep it like that. Because it's still not number one. Which is just not my type of thing. So we got a little B there. Now we're on to Giants. Oh, so floaty. Flying. Oh, here it comes. It's running it in. And then it's gonna go like, boom.
Take a hit of anything to escape it all. I'm suffocating. A sharpened blade of reality. Sometimes I wanna hurt me. I know it's hard to hear, but I'm waiting for the new year. Don't wanna waste my life chasing white. Try to swim towards the light. Coming up for air in the deepest of the deep ends. I thought I learned it all, but boom, the plot thickens. Sleeping with giants, I'm tiptoeing quietly. I could leave one thing for you. It's exactly what not to do. I'm so proud of you. Forever in the deepest of the deep end. I thought I learned it all, but boom, the plot thickens. Sleeping with giants, I'm tiptoeing quietly.
So this song, I think it has to, I've been basically since the chorus before he maxed out the mic, I've been trying to debate on whether or not this goes in A or B, because it's not average and it's not ass cheeks, but it's obviously not as good as Radioactive. Now, the reason I'm debating it is because the part where he's saying the coming up for air in the deepest of the deep ends.
Coming up for air in the deepest of the deep ends.
That part sounds kind of weird as fuck to me. But then, all the way up till he says, feeling it all, this sobriety. After that, when it gets to the la-la-las, it makes up for that. And then the bridge is good up until the take a look at what I've been through. I've just heard that ending of the chorus was like, okay, that's A. So it makes up for the B by the deepest of the deep ends. We're looking at an A after the chorus. The bridge, it's looking good until the last line. Because there's screamo. And there's like, you know, doing the fucking thing where you scream. And then there's this. It just doesn't sound good in my opinion.
Not to do. I'm so proud of you. Coming up forever in the deepest of the deep end. I thought I learned it all.
So that whole part, I think, brings it down to a B. I think overall the message of the song is very good. I think this is something that, like, from February until July, this song means a lot to me. I think that that's good. And I think that ever since just being completely sober, I felt so much more motivated and happy. The rest of the song is nice. It's not average. Because number one, again, number one is just not really my thing. I don't know if I'd listen to this on my own time, especially in headphones. I might go deaf. So now we have It's Okay. It looks like maybe it'll be a nice little, I don't know, love song. That's my... Oh, don't want to hear the rest of that. Okay.
She could always hear every word they say. Everybody walks like they just know the way. Every single day, holding back the tears, she'd never say a word, 'cause there's nobody that hears. It's okay. Confused. It's okay to be not okay. I need you here with me. Time to be out of your mind. I can't do it all alone. Just a day at a time. It's okay. It's okay. Out of your mind. Out of your mind. It's okay to be not okay. I need you here with me. Time to be out of your mind.
So it's okay. I think that this is not going to be the popular opinion, but I see this as kind of like another version of Monday. I think that they're both trying to accomplish the same thing of like making you happy and realizing it's all good. Now, the popular opinion is I bet a lot of people are going to like this song, because they're going to say it sounds a lot like old Imagine Dragons. And so a big thing that people do when they don't like the new songs is they're like, it's not, we need more like the old Imagine Dragons. But so this song, honestly, again, like I said, it's the unpopular opinion, but it's going to go an average. I think it does sound like old Imagine Dragons, but I don't really need someone saying that everything's okay. Monday just seems a lot more like catchy, like I want to get up and dance. Like, I also forgot how fire the beginning of Monday was. So that part right there just makes me feel more like when they're both trying to go for the happy. And I think that Monday accomplishes better than It's Okay. So It's Okay, I think, is an average song. That's the unpopular opinion. I think people are going to put It's Okay in the A tier if they were making it. But I don't think so. I think you got two different songs trying to do the same thing. And I think that Monday did it better. I'm also a sucker for like little synths. This part, I think it's like so sick. Oh, thanks, Fences. Like the whole like synth pop. I just really like the sounds to a lot of that shit. But so now we're on to Dull Knives. That is not how I expected it to start.
Holding my breath, holding so tight. Nothing is wrong, nothing is right. I'm in the dark, looking for light.
Won't someone please save my life? Inside I'm a mess, but I don't let it show. Just hanging on, but you never know. I smile all day and cry through the night. Won't someone please save my life? It's fleeting.
There it is. That's what I expected. So this is what I think about Dull Knives. I think that it's going to be going into the B tier. I don't think it's quite average, but I think there's some things that are really holding it back from being an A. Now, I think one, like, this is a song I feel like I would hear at Warped Tour if I were going to that in high school. And that doesn't mean it's a bad song. You could just tell that obviously they're trying something different, which obviously I applaud. And I think that it could be very good. Except I don't know that Dan Reynolds is meant to do the screaming. Specifically, like, all of it is normally, it's actually not bad until he says towards my spine. And that is like, the man couldn't even like do it, is what it seems like. Now, of course, I couldn't do it either. So I applaud him for trying. But it's not my thing. That part. So, and then it makes up for it with the guitar solo too. I think that's good. My man Wayne Sermon. But I think it's a B. Maybe it would go on my driving playlist, but I don't know if I'd be listening to that on my own time. I think if I wanted to hear something like that, I'd listen to like Black Veil Brides. So now we're up to the two other singles on the album. So I've heard both of these, but we'll listen to it anyways. You know, they're good songs.
You know I got your number all night. I'm always on your team, I got your back, alright. Taking those losses if it treats you right. I wanna put you into the spotlight. If the world would only know what you've been holding back. Heart attacks every night. Oh, you know it's not right. I will follow you way down, wherever you may go. Enough love. She live a life hand in a tight glove. I wish that I could fix it. I could fix it for you. But instead I'll be right here coming through.
Okay, Now this, I don't know if maybe this will be an unpopular opinion. I think I'm going to put this up here as good as Radioactive. Now, the first time I listened to the song, honestly, it was like three times I listened to the song, I was like, eh, it's kind of good. Like, when you match it, when you compare it to singles, like, Whatever It Takes, when that came out, the first time I listened to it, I was like, this song is a fucking banger. And then I remember when Whatever It Takes came out as a single, I was in the library my senior year, or no, it would have been junior year of high school, and I was writing an essay, and I listened to it on repeat for like an hour and a half because it was just that good. And other songs like Bad Liar was up there with, I was instantly like, this song is very good. Now Follow You, it took a few times to listen to it, but then like, and I think that it was because the few times I listened to it, I was also like really sad. And so I was listening to songs about like the end of the world and like my Pink Floyd. But then when I started going on the upward trend, I thought this song was a banger. And then they released a quote-unquote summer edition, and it's so good. I think Follow You is as good as Radioactive, because I don't think Radioactive is some, like, all-holy legendary thing to behold. I think it's just a very, very, very good song, and I think Follow You is a very, very, very good song. Now, the next single is not going to be as good as Radioactive. Cutthroat. I have some things to say about Cutthroat, but we will listen to it, and then I'll say it afterwards. We'll see what you have to say about it.
I've been waiting patiently. I built this tower quietly, and when my well of Wellbutrin is running dry of serotonin, I can say things I don't mean, or maybe it's the truth in me. Bubbling up, my time is up.
I'm so misunderstood, but I live for this. My money's good, and I came to win. So step on up, and I promise you, only one of us gonna make it out alive, and it's not you. Only one of us, only one of us gonna make it out alive, and it's not you. Only one of us,
only one of us gonna make it out alive.
So Cutthroat, I see it as this. I think that the song was intended to be with that Radioactive rock kind of feel. Now, I'm pretty sure that it was also produced by Rick Rubin, who I think did a lot of stuff for like Kanye West and other rappers. Like, he's a big rap name. Also, sick fucking beard. Yeah, Kanye West, Eminem. So like rap stuff. Jay-Z, apparently Ed Sheeran. And so I think that I can tell that is definitely the case, because it does some like weird stuff, but I just don't really like it. I think that it's another good example of Mr. Reynolds screaming. I don't really like, but I do also remember them posting about how like he was thanking Rick Rubin for making him try something new. And so again, I'm always one for always try something new. I like people trying to innovate, but it's not really my thing. I'm basing this off of, there are a few Imagine Dragons songs that like, I think one, for example, is Dancing in the Dark. It was the end of their Evolve album, and I heard it and I was like, that is just the worst. Like, Cutthroat is one that if it comes on its own and I'm kind of off doing something else, I'll listen to it, but it's not something I'm like, wow, I want to listen to Cutthroat today. But we have two songs left, both of which I have not heard. It's time for No Time for Toxic People.
The way they look at me, I know exactly what they talk about when I'm not around. Got no time for that. As a matter of fact, every day's my birthday. Oh, I hope you heard me.
For Toxic People. I think that No Time for Toxic People is, which is very good that my tier list ended up like this, because I think this is exactly the perfect spot for No Time for Toxic People. This is basically, to me, that is right there with the same type of songs as Monday, and It's Okay. Now, as I said previously, Monday gets the job done, making me feel happier, better than It's Okay does. And I think that No Time for Toxic People is not as good as Monday, but I think it's better than It's Okay. And so I think it's a B, because it's not bad. That's one that it would be, I don't know, if I'm trying to just fucking chill, it'd be there. But that's good. And now we're down to one final song, One Day.
I know that one day I'll be that one thing that makes you happy. I know I keep you laughing. Your sun on a cloudy day, the feel of a perfect wave, it's crashing upon your face. Yeah, I know that one day the sun will sing me a song tonight. I know that it's right on time. Better off without them. Yeah, I know that one day ooh, one day
ooh. It like pains me to do it, but I have to put it in average. I think that this could have easily been an A or a B. But when I think of like their songs, will I want to listen to One Day, or would I want to listen to something like West Coast? Which they're singing about the same thing, but one makes me just want to fucking like just be so happy. One makes me want to love my girlfriend more than the other one. Like the chorusness.
I could be better, but my love I won't give up. I ain't no Superman, I ain't no Holy Ghost. I'm just the one that keeps you up and now you love the most. I'll be a strong man, I'll be a West Coast. I'll be the sun, I'll be the waves, I'll be the one you love the most.
So that is my example of, like, one day in West Coast, I feel like we're trying to do the same thing. I would probably put West Coast almost up there with As Good As Radioactive. This is the final album. There are no ass cheeks, so I'll give an example if some of you have thought maybe some of this is ass cheeks. The reason that I don't have any in ass cheeks is because this is what I think of when I think of ass cheeks in Imagine Dragons.
Around here like that, you could get us in some trouble. Looking that way, and Monday, you got me. That's a fact. You could get me in some trouble. Looking that way, and I don't need nobody. If you ever wanna. Dancing in the dark.
So that's all we need. To me, that is what ass cheeks is, and that's why there are none here, because I don't think any of these songs were bad necessarily. I think the ones that were average are just kind of like, they're not my thing, but they're not like shitty songs. Like people, the majority of people probably won't hate on it. Like, people are probably going to put No Time for Toxic People as good as Radioactive if they're making this list. Because, one, I think people are just so down with the phrase toxic people that they'll just include it in as much as they can. They're like, don't need that toxicity in my life. Toxic is a huge word nowadays, and I don't feel like it always was. I think that that's something new in the modern day. So, yeah, I think that this album overall, I'd say it's a good album. I mean, all of their albums are pretty damn good. Like, in terms of if you're putting the ratio from good to bad songs, the ratio is always generally good. But that is for another tier list. We're looking specifically at this album, and I don't think it's bad. I think it's a good album, but I would not say it's their best. I'm definitely going to add My Life and Monday to my playlists. And I don't know. I'll think about the Bees. The Bees are nice songs. It's just not as good as these. Follow You is fantastic, and that's really it. So that's how I would rank the new Imagine Dragons album. Thank you to everyone watching the YouTube video. I hope you enjoyed, and be sure to comment down below. What are your favorite songs? How would you change my tier list after listening to this album? Everyone, have a beautiful night. I will see you all on Monday, baby. Oh, wait. I will see you all Monday, baby.
Danda, 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 danda.